During the time of Buddha or in Buddha's viharas, viharas basically is a term used where Buddha used to stay. So in Buddha's viharas, silence was the most notable factor. It is said that in Buddha's viharas, not only Buddha, but many prominent Buddha's disciple, they can sit in complete silence, not for 1 hour, 2 hour, one day, up to 7 days and seven nights non-stop in complete silence. Now, of course, that's a very high stage of meditation. For normal people, basically like us, even if you can sit with us for 1 hour non-stop, in complete silence, without any body movement, without any speech, it's a great achievement. It's a good achievement, actually. I mean, initially people can even start to begin with even 10 or 20 minutes of complete silence. So anyhow, the silence basically was a very notable factor. So it's called noble silence. And then there's a second step called noble speech. I will explain exactly what does it mean. So there is a reason behind it. Very deep reason behind it. If anybody wants to experience very deep inner peace or inner happiness, or in our language we call divine peace, divine happiness, you need a very deep meditation, or I will say you need a practice of very deep concentration. Only with a very deep concentration of mind you can experience that inner peace, inner happiness. And deep concentration of mind cannot be achieved unless your mind is very calm. And mind basically, for a mind to become very calm, you need basically peace, silence, complete silence. Body completely still. Voice, of course, not speaking at all. I mean, speech is silence. And then basically when you sit for longer duration, where your body is still, no speech, eyes closed, and then slowly, 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 mind also started becoming still. And where's the basically mind started becoming still, stiller and stiller. And that is a point you started experiencing deeper, start getting connecting inside. And you start experiencing peace, you start experiencing happiness. And the more your mind is calm, the more peace and happiness you can experience. And that's basically what Buddha, Gautama the Buddha, wanted everybody to experience, that inner peace, inner happiness, infinite source of inner peace and inner happiness. And once you start experiencing that inner peace and happiness, all the worldly money, power, fame, the happiness which one derives from them becomes a secondary things, immaterial. And that's basically where I made another video where I explained that Buddha story, inner peace and inner happiness versus money, power, fame. I will give a link of the in the description about 10 minutes or 20 minutes meditation in case if you want to practice. If you have any query, feel free to write it in the comment section and I will be happy to answer it. Thank you very much for watching this video.